Henrique developing into a significant problem?
I don't think so. You know, when you say significant problem, you know, I think I can consider Travis Zajac a significant problem. You know, he's missed that kind of time. I think this is a groin injury that we're being careful with to make sure that he's available long-term, especially considering our circumstances here.
Some guys that have those sort of lingering groin injuries consider or get, you know, that sports hernia surgery. Do
right.
you know if that has been
no,
discussed or ruled
yeah,
out? Or,
no, that's okay. not a that's not the case in okay. this in this injury. No.
But he won't play tomorrow, right? You expect to have Patrick tomorrow?
Yes.
Do you not even want to contemplate what it would be like not to have him tomorrow with all the other injuries?
No. No.
How about Bryce?
Yeah, he'll play tomorrow. I mean, that's the plan as of today. You know, it's some maintenance on a couple guys like Eliash and Bryce who play big minutes and need rest on days like this.
He didn't play really late in the game. Was that a coach's decision or was that related to this?
No, that was more coaching. I mean, we were down by a goal. You know, I think we were going with some offensive defensemen, more of a push that way. I think, you know, it had nothing to do with the injury.
He seemed to, early in the game, hurt his left leg.
Yeah.
Did he play hurt the whole game?
I think he did. Looking back now, you know, based on what we're seeing today, that he did battle through a minor injury there during the game.
With Clarkson, you know, having sort of the wealth of experience you have with him throughout yeah. his career, did you see this, like, I guess, sort of potential in him when he... What type of player was he?
Yeah. You know, I mean, he's a real similar player to what he is now. He was a guy that was on the ice. You know, everybody in the building knew he was on the ice. You know, the fans, the other team. You know, he draws attention to himself. And at the same time, for me, he's always been a big game goal scorer. He's found a way, you know, in overtimes, in the playoffs, in big games, to rise to the occasion and score. He has that ability. And we've seen it this year. I mean, an overtime winner in Toronto. You know, he scores last night to tie it up. You know, he has that ability at key times to find a way to get a goal. And, you know, that's one of his great characteristics.
Just as a guy that has the, you know, the toughness that he does, have you
yeah.
seen guys like that kind of get underappreciated for the
Yeah, you know what? I don't know if they're underappreciated. I think they're rare. They're few and far between, and that's why they're valuable. You know, you look at the Lucic's of the world. You know, that's probably the best comparable. The Bertuzzi's. You know, not that Clarkie's going to be a 40 goal scorer, but you know, those guys that combine, you know, that physical power forward game with the fact that they'll drop the gloves and fight anybody, are hard to find those guys.
Do you ever, you know, worry about him now? Do you ever want him to say, hey, that's not a guy I want you to fight, that's a bad trade for us?
Yeah.
Does he have to be more discerning in that?
Yeah, for sure. We have those conversations. You know, we talk a lot about walking that line where he's still a presence, but he's doing it in the right way. And, you know, he knows that line's moved from where it was early in his career, where he was fighting every night just to stay in the league, to, you know, now he's got he's a valuable part of our lineup.
This homestand started out before they got a chance, though, tomorrow to end it, you know, and get off on a good note
yeah.
in Philly, right?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I mean, the emotional win and everything we did last night, you know, really only counts as if we win tomorrow night. So, and that's how the season's going to go here as you go forward. So it was nice to enjoy the win, you know. But today it's back to business because critical 2 points tomorrow night.
Is that, though, the kind of win you can build off of going forward?
Yeah, I hope so. You know, you come in, you have some confidence. I mean, you know, the NHL season is about riding those waves. You know, when things are going good, extending those winning streaks as long as you can, and nipping the losing streaks in the bud. And I think that's what we did last night. You know, coming off the three losses the week prior to the All-Star game, and you know, now we've hopefully got to turn this one into a run.
Is Josefsson still kind of finding his way after such a long layoff? Do you feel him coming along? See him coming along? Or?
Yeah, I mean, I see him coming along, but you know, this is a kid that you know, has missed a significant amount of time. Is jumping into the league, you know, at probably its highest point until playoffs, with the way the desperation is and how teams are playing for points right now. It's not an easy spot for him to jump into, you know, with limited number of games. So, and he's a young guy. He doesn't have a 10-year history or a career under his belt where he's had long-term success here. So he's dealing with some things, and we'll, but we need him, and you know, we're going to push him to keep raising his level.
I can ask you a question regarding Martin Brodeur. Every time he's playing against Montreal, we're talking about when Martin was playing on him.
Yeah.
He said today and yesterday that he's still in love with the game and for him it will be tough. What's your own opinion about Brodeur and the way he's playing?
Well, I think he's playing very well. You know, I think we talked yesterday that, you know, the comfort I take in our stretch drive here is that we have guys in our room that, and he's right at the top of that list, that have the ability of raising their level of play this time of year and in the playoffs. And, you know, between him and the Eliashes and the Sikoras and, you know, the Kovalchuks and the Parises, those guys, you know, they've risen to the occasion this time of year in the past. They're second half type players, and he's right at the top of that list. So, you know, I expect big things from him here down the stretch.
Do you need to give him more rest now at 39?
You know, I think he needs a little bit more rest, but he would sit and tell you that that he doesn't. And, you know, that's the competitive side of him, and that's good. So he wants to play a lot. I think we've managed his workload well this year in that he feels fresh going into the stretch here, which is, you know, what the goal was coming into the season. So I think we're in a good spot.
How long do you think he can keep it up? I mean, he's talking like he wants to do.
Yeah, you know what? I mean, hopefully for a long time. You know, I look at Dwayne Rolson, who led Tampa in the playoffs last year, and he was 42. You know, so as long as that fire is burning, you know, and his body, and he stays healthy, that's the biggest thing for him.